Get ready for College Hoops 2K8. The Georgetown Hoyas square up against the Connecticut Huskies. This is going to be a terrific matchup. Hello, basketball fans. We're here at the Harry A. Gamble Pavilion. This is Vern Lundquist with Bill Raftery and Tracy Wilson. Give us your take, Bill.
The story here is a matchup at off guard. Number 44 is definitely one of the best shooting guards in the nation. He's so strong from the line. Give him two free throws, he'll give you 2 points. Number 4 is also in the discussion of the nation's best two guards. He's an outstanding defender in the low post, and he has wonderful fundamental skills down there. Both looking to lead their teams to a win. We'll see who succeeds.
Gets the tip, and we're underway.
The game has just begun, and they're already in the minute.
Number 11, the crossover. Dishes it to the right. Takes it up. Snatched off a defensive glass by number 55.
Oh, you can't come across the body like that. That is a textbook reach.
Copeland inbounds the ball. Number 55. Steal by Connecticut. It's one-on-one. Hamilton picks it up. Puts it down. They're in front, 2-0. Let's check in with our sideline reporter, Tracy Wilson, who has some info for us.
Just before the game, I caught up with Coach Calhoun. He said he spent a lot of time on the chalkboard this week, adding a few extra wrinkles to their offensive game plan. He said, against a team that is as sophisticated defensively as they are, we have to add some looks that they haven't seen before, and I think we've done that.
Thanks, Tracy.
What agile moves. Not too many guys can use the finger roll anymore, but he does it with style.
That last rebound is gained by Hamilton. Pulls it in. About 3.5 minutes left in the half.
Nice work by the big fella to get that rebound.
Swing pass, right wing. Number 11. Backs in. Goes up. Good by Newland. They push their lead to 5. On the low ball. Number 35 inbounds the ball. Number 11 brings it up court. Hands it off. Nice little crossover. Last four players by number 11.
Look at this little guy getting it done down low. You love to see him in there.
The alley-oop. Number 11 throws the pass offline, and it heads out of bounds.
These guys are having trouble with fundamental team play, Vern. As that turnover shows you, they don't have much in the way of chemistry at the moment.
Passes it to the wing. Number 4. Good from downtown. It's now all knotted up 7. 2:09 left in the first half. Number 44 gets it. Right wing. Hamilton. Number 35 tosses it up. Connects inside the key. And they lead by 2. Number 55. Inbounds the ball. Number 11. Nice little crossover. Has it. inside. Number 35 dishes it to the top of the key. Top of the key. Bounces it to the left wing. Number 44 throws it up. Buried from beyond the arc by number 11. He's got three. Puts it up. Number 35 snatches it down inside. 1:07 left in the first half.
Oh, the big fella with a tough rebound. No denying him on that one.
Number 55 passes it up court. Hopkins catches it upright.
Coach Calhoun made some changes that could affect their chemistry a little bit. I don't think these guys have played together very often.
He's up on the set. Goes up. Collected inside by number 11. He attacked it with everything he had, but it still wasn't enough.
Good defense, not letting him jam it home.
Hamilton dumps it off. Number 11, then 20 feet out, hits it.
Coach Thompson got the momentum slipping away from his team, and I'm sure he's hoping this time out will straighten them out.
Zero inbounds the ball. 2 second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. Left wing. Number 4 knocks it down from 3-point land. And they're now behind by 4. Goes to the crossover. Puts it up. Copeland stops the last second shot. Nice D. First half comes to an end with the score 14-10. What do you think of the first half, Bill?
If we don't see some improvement soon, this could be even further out of reach. They need to make some adjustments.
Now we'll bring you our player of the half. Who's your pick, Bill?
Number 11
is my pick, Vern. He's led his team in the first half with outstanding play on both ends of the floor. I don't think he's done, though. I expect more of the same from him in the second half.
Solid performance from our player of the half. We're ready to begin the second half. Number 55 inbounds it to start the second half. White. Bold pass. Gets it outside. Dishes to the right. Number 55.
Terrific pass there. I love the way this fella dishes it out, Vern.
Let's check in with Tracy Wolfson.
Well, at halftime, I talked with Coach Calhoun. He said that he isn't satisfied with the small lead and is going to try to force the issue in the second half. Coach told me that he wasn't going to play this next half by the book and that he'll try things that some might call counterintuitive. I guess we'll see what he means soon enough. Back to you, Vern.
Okay, Tracy. We'll see if he got the message across with the crossover. Number 11 puts it up. No good from 3-point land. Still a 2-point lead. Skip pass, baseline. Good job on the layup by Copeland. He's 1-for-2 for the game. number 35, inbounds the ball.
There's no question what kind of defense they're in, Byrne. Minimum.
Number 11, uses the crossover. Good from 12 feet. The Hoyas call timeout. Both teams are going to shake things up a little bit with some subs.
Georgetown looks like they want to put some more experience on the floor, and they're bringing on a senior for the freshman.
About 3.5 minutes left in the second half. Number 4. Gets it. Right wing. Number 44 gets the board inside. He got it up there, but it just wouldn't fall.
With a little more touch, it might have.
Number 11 feeds it to the wing. That last rebound is just by number 44.
Nolan pulled down that offensive board like it was no problem. What a backward.
Takes it up. Foul and hard there. They've got 2 free throws. He misses the first. Good on number 2. Number 55 inbounds the ball.
The student section is whooping it up now. How much fun are they having?
Those fans are a special group, Bill. They get way into it. Cuts off the pass. It's one-on-one. Leads him with the pass. Georgetown carries it up. Left wing. Campbell dishes to the top of the key. Copeland has it in the paint. The three was drained by number 55. And it's all knotted up. Number 35. Hamilton pulls the trigger. Listen to this crowd go crazy, Bill. What fans we've got in here today. He's shooting 100% for the game. Hupkin inbounds the ball to the paint. Puts it up. And it's controlled by Connecticut.
Who's more worried about scoring? That's why you squeeze it, young fella.
Number 35 backs him down. Shoots the turnaround right in the bottom of the bucket. There they hit. 22-17. 1:44 left in the game. Getting set to inbound the ball. Beats it to the right wall. He rips down the rebound. Nolan. Number 35 is called for the charge. That's his first foul.
How about the job by the defender there? Way to step in front and take the charge, young fellow.
The Hoyas, all time. They're losing by 5. 1:31 left in the game. Copeland inbounds the ball. Georgetown is really struggling. With the soft touch. But they're still behind by 3. The crossover. Hamilton dumps it off. Has it. Left side. Down low. Nolan. A huge blunder on that 3-second violation. This is a crucial possession. Dumps it inside. Stolen away by Connecticut.
Wonderful job of getting the basketball that time. Great pick.
Number 54 inbounds the ball. 1 second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. Campbell. Now
Copeland.
Incredible display of offensive firepower.
It's been this way all game, Bill, and you have to wonder if one of these two teams will eventually run out of gas. Number three has picked up his first foul of the game. The foul stops the clock, which is just what the doctor ordered.
And that's why they did it. Time is not on their side. Very smart play.
Hembrick just picked up his third foul of the game.
Good foul there. They need the ball back as soon as possible.
Hembrick now has four fouls.
Well, no choice but the foul. They've got to stop the clock and get the ball back right away.
Number 35 inbounds the ball. Number 4 has picked up his second foul.
Good foul there. They need the ball back as soon as possible.
Number 4
fouls in.
Bonus situation in effect. So they'll head to the line for a 1-1. The foul stops the clock, which is just what the doctor ordered.
And that's why they did it. Time is now on their side. Very smart play. Those are silly fingers. That should put the game away. Pump loose.
And it's gathered up by number 35. Copeland fires from the right block. Missed. That's the ball game. The Huskies knock off Georgetown, 28-21. And now it's time to show you our player of the game. Now let's go back to Greg Gumbel with today's version of the Pontiac game-changing performance.
Hi, and welcome everyone to the 2K Sports Studios. I'm Greg Gumbel, and we're going to bring you our Pontiac game-changing performance. There are some shots that simply crush the spirit of an opponent. The Connecticut Huskies delivered this dagger to the heart in the closing minutes, and it was quite simply the biggest shot of the game.
Okay, thanks, Greg. This is Vern Lundquist for Tracy Wilson and Bill Raftery. Glad you were here with us for College Hoops 2K8.